The next topic that we would like to explore is deployments. Next set of question that we have to answer is how we are going to deploy the new version of the application. If something goes wrong, how we are going to roll back? Is replica set good enough? Let's give it a try. I have no pods running for the Dobby application. I have my Dobby replica set where I'm setting the environment variable version to 1.0. Let's deploy this replica set. I have this running as a node port service as well, so I can connect from my host machine directly. Let's do curl version 1.0 showing up. Let's go ahead and make a change to my application here. And I want to specify version 2.0. Let's try and apply this file again. So it is configured, but you will notice that there is no change that has happened here. These pods are still running, the same pod. If I try to hit the URL, no change. If I just do kubectl delete rs and reapply this new changed descriptor YAML, new pods are created. If I try and hit the version URL, I'll see the version is changed. However, when I try to deploy change version on the existing running replica set, it did not pick up the change. Let me show you one more time. Change version to 3.0. Try to apply. The pods are still running. The version is still 2.0. I have to delete the replica set and recreate the replica set. Then only the new changes are getting applied. So ideally, most of the time, what will change is the image version. You will have a new version of the image that you would like to deploy for your new changes in the application. So replica set is not good enough. I had to delete and redeploy replica set to get the change effective. So what is missing in replica set is I want to update my application and achieve zero downtime, which is through rolling update. And also, if something goes wrong, should be able to roll back to the previous revision. That's the ability that I want. And exactly that's the job of deployment. A deployment is another level of abstraction that manages replica sets and provides the declarative way of upgrading and rollback of pods, which means our application. So the job of deployment provides declarative upgradability to pod using replica set. Remember that it uses replica set internally, and it is abstraction on top of replica set. Let's see how it works. So I have a current state, which is revision 1, deployed in the Kubernetes cluster. I have three pods, A, B, and C, which is marked as revision 1. Now I want to deploy revision 2. My client sends the request to deploy revision 2 to API server of control plane. What it does is it creates another replica set and start spinning up the pod inside this new replica set. As the new pod are created, the old pods are removed from the previous replica set. So the final new state is revision 2. And replica set R1 is there, but no pods running in the replica set. If I want to roll back, I send the request to, and it will happen exactly the reverse way. The pods are getting removed from the replica set R2 and pods are getting recreated in the replica set R1. The definition of the replica set R1 is still there. It is just that the number of pods are increasing and decreasing. A replica set descriptor YAML looks like this. The only difference between replica set and deployment descriptor is the kind object. The rest all is similar. Let's see the deployment in action. So I just have one Hello Node pod running right now and no other replica set or anything. In this watch window, I'm watching on the deployment. This watch window is showing me all the replica set. I have my Dobby deployment ready. The only difference is kind from the replica set to deployment. I'm running 6 replica of Dobby application. My readiness probe and liveness probe are also configured. Now onwards, I should have de facto my readiness probe, liveness probe always in my container spec. My environment variable is set to version 3.0. Let's run this. The Dobby deployment is created. The replica set is created with a random suffix. 6 desired, 6 current running, getting into the ready state. It's taking time for the ready because my readiness probe is not responded yet. Okay, now started getting ready, and you will see the endpoint also getting added. So all 6 pods are ready, serving request. Let's hit the curl URL and see the version. So version 3.0. Let's put this version check into the while loop. Okay. Showing up version 3.0. I have another window here that I opened up. We'll go and change this version to version 4.0. Applying the Dobby deployment, same name. You'll notice that another replica set is created with the desired count 5 right now. And the old one is reduced to 3. Slowly, you will notice that this goes to 6 and the old one reduces to 0. So the new replica set, which is age 58, is at 5 desired state, now 6, and this has reduced to 2. Since I have given a delay in my readiness probe, initial delay of 20 seconds, I am able to showcase this. Generally, my initial delay is not that high because my Go application starts very quickly within second. I should not give more than 2-3 seconds delay there. I have a new replica set, which is 99 seconds ago with all the 6 desired count. I'll again change my version to showcase this one more time. Also notice that the version 4 is showing up here, and slowly you'll see the version 5 also getting shown in the response. As and when the new replica set ready count increases, you'll see the version here changing. See, ready count increased to 3. You'll see mix of version 4 and version 5 here. There is no downtime. My all requests are getting responded. And after some time, you will see that all to version 5. So all 6 ready state, the endpoints are also updated. You can keep pushing your new versions. If you want to see how many versions you have deployed for this, kubectl rollout, history, deployment Dobby. You're going to notice that I have deployed 3 versions, version 3, 4, and 5. The revision is the number of deployments that you have done. 1, 2, and 3. These are the 3 revisions that I have. Look at this revision to find out how many times I have deployed the different version. There is a column also called change cause. You can specify this while deploying. So to give the change cause, either use the command line option or specify this change cause in your deployment descriptor. So if I go to the deployment descriptor with annotation, in the metadata, I can specify annotation where I say Kubernetes change cause and give my message. You can use generally the message which is your git SHA so that you know which version we present to which git commit, and you can trace it back to your actual source code as well. Let's just deploy this. I'll just give this version as, let's say, right now we are on 5, so I'll give it 6. Now my file name is with annotation. Again, because it's the same deployment name, created another replica set. And remember that all the old replica set are still there, right? And I'll show you how to roll back as well. To go from 5 to 6, because my version is 6 there. In this, I've reduced to 2 replica set. Good. 2 pods. Current state 2, ready 2, all good. Endpoints updated. The previous is still getting terminated. That's fine. So now let's look at the history. You notice that we have a message there. Now, if I want to go back to the previous revision, I can say kubectl rollout undo, and which deployment I want to undo and to which revision I want to go back to. If I don't specify the revision, we'll just go back to previous revision, which is revision version 5. So you'll notice that now it has reused the previous replica set. So this was the last with 2, right? And this is the previous one that you see here. Now the desired count is 1. It has kept the number of replicas as it is. It has just rolled back the whole pod specification to the previous one, right? And replica set is reused. If I specify the 2 revision, if I want to go back to the revision 1, which is version 3.0. So from 5, should see 3.0 here. So it has picked up the oldest age, which was the first deployment that I specified, 10 minutes age replica set. You see 3.0 started showing up here, version 3.0. If I go ahead and do kubectl rollout history, I'll see that the revision number has changed. So 1 and 3 is gone now, and 5 and 6 are added in the revision. I have to make sure that I use the revision number wherever I want to roll back to. Another feature of deployment is you can specify the rollout strategy. Let's look at that. So the default strategy is rolling update tag inside your spec for deployment, where you can specify the strategy. One is rolling update, another one is recreate. In rolling update, you can specify if you have 100 pods, how much you want to increase in the surge and how much is okay to have unavailable. If I have 100 pods, I specify 10%, which means that will create a 10 new pods and it will reduce the 10 pods from the old one. So 10 new, 10 old, keep going like that, and it'll achieve your final state where all the pods are shifted to newer version. The another strategy is recreate. Let's see the recreate strategy. I've given the version 11. Notice here that right now I'm on version 3.0. I'm giving the recreate strategy, which will take me to version 11. However, you notice gone zero straight. No ready pod. New replica set created with desired count 6, because I have 6 replicas here, but the application is down. All the previous pods are terminated first and the new pod are created. And when it becomes available, ready, then only the service is going to start responding to. Now you are ready, your endpoints have started adding up, right? And you are getting the response for 11.0. If you have your application which is backward compatible, and can coexist between previous version and new version, then you can use rolling update, which will give you the zero downtime. If you don't have a backward compatibility, you might have to choose for recreate, but remember that it can give you momentarily downtime for your service. That's all I have for the deployment demo. Exercise 6, you know what to do. Create deployment object for metadata as well as Mongo database. Even if you have one pod, recommendation is always use deployment. Do not use replica set or pods directly without deployment, so that you can deploy new version of MongoDB as well.